गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग द चैप्टर रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म. डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स वी डिस्कस्ड, लाइक व्हाट इज रेस्पिरेशन, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन, देयर यूजेस, देन रेस्पिरेशन इन प्लांट्स. नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक दैट इज रेस्पिरेशन इन एनिमल्स, इन विच वी डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स, देन देयर रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम एंड the process of respiration in animals. Students, in small animals, the exchange of gases take place by diffusion through their overall body surface. In large animals, there are organs which help in bringing oxygen from the air inside the body, so that cellular respiration can take place easily. Now, I'm going to discuss the respiration in different animals. What are the ways how they respire? The first one is the small organism like amoeba and hydra. In these organisms, oxygen enters and carbon dioxide goes out through the simple process of diffusion. They are very small organisms. They do not have a system of respiration or special organs for respiration. In these animals, in these organisms, oxygen enters and carbon dioxide goes out through the simple process of diffusion. In earthworms and leech, skin is the organ for exchange of gases. It is smooth, moist and richly supplied with blood, and by the exchange of gases, oxygen enters directly into the blood and then carbon dioxide goes out of the body. In fish, prawns and crabs, the respiratory organs are the gills. Oxygen-rich water enters through the mouth and oxygen-deficient water leaves through the gills. Fishes breathe by drinking water. A pressurized gulp of water flows from the mouth into the gills chamber on each side of the head. Gills located in gill clefts within the gill chambers consist of fleshy sheet-like filaments transected by extensions called lamellae. As water flows across the gills, the oxygen contained in it diffuses into the blood and is circulated through vessels in the filaments and lamellae. Simultaneously, carbon dioxide in the fish blood stream diffuses into the water and is carried out of the body. A fish can close the operculae or flaps of tissues covering the gill openings to prevent water from escaping. This is the process of breathing in fish. They breathe through the special organ, that is gills. Insects have a network of branched tubes called trachea for respiration. These trachea open on the surface of their bodies through pores, and through these pores, oxygen enters the body and carbon dioxide exhales out of the body. Some of the animals have very well-developed spongy organs called lungs for respiration. In mammals, structures like diaphragm and ribcage support the process of breathing. Many of you might have observed the movement of ribs in cows, dogs, and small babies while they are sleeping. We will discuss about the respiration in human being in detail in the next session. So that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.